our industry, particularly the reinsurance industry, has been successful for a number of years. Success, however, goes through waves at the end. With such success, can we really imagine the words disruption or permanent change? To my mind, we better do, because if we don't, no complex experience in an area such as insurance, no processes, no protection around protectionism at the end of the day, an environment, regulatory environment, no relationships, and most important, no regulation from a governmental point of view. Disruption doesn't necessarily mean bad news. Disruption, from my point of view, in Europe particularly, industry means good news. Who would have thought 100 years back that companies' assets, insurers' assets, brokers' assets, are primarily be driven by what so-called intangible assets? Look at some of the startup companies today. It's all about the brand, it's all about the data, it's all about the talent you bring to the table, it is all about your reputation, and it's all about particular customer relationship. The customer is centric, but in a true meaning centric. If you control data, you can price. If you can price, you can come out with products or solutions which others can't. If you have industry knowledge, even better. But at the same token, there are certain threats. The more a risk becomes intangible, the less we can look at statistics, actuarial modeling from the past. Cyber risks, for instance, are risks which have a high potential severity, a high potential frequency, global implications, fully man-made, challenges related to our customers, challenges related to some of the events we currently see, recent, probably capital events, are exponentially growing. Digitalization, however, is becoming the new order of the day, and thereby connecting our conventional businesses on the one side with strategies beyond the obvious at an unprecedented rate. Asia being the most populated continent, it depends the region in which I strongly believe not just the future is going to be, but where technology goes beyond the obvious, where probably the revolution as far as some of the insurance aspects are being driven. What should we watch out if we look going forward? The rising growth of mobile devices, social media network developments, and the acceptance of online commerce. Exponential growth means exponential value development of intangible assets. And the more value an intangible asset has, the bigger the risk. Look at some companies in the past. Look at a company like Northern Telecom a couple of years ago, one of the largest telecommunication equipment manufacturers. From one second to the other, the company was gone. Asia today roughly represents 60% globally of the population. Today, we have 4.3 billion subscriptions of mobile phones around the world. 58% of those 4.3 billion, which means 2.3 billion, are coming out of Asia. Asia is by far the fastest expanding regional economy. Companies such as Samsung, Xiaomi, such as Sony, represent today, together with Huawei, already 70% of the market. 33% of the app developers we have around the world are based in Asia. Technology companies are heavily intangible asset driven. They need new solutions. They have, some of them are not aware, significant cyber exposure, which I will talk about. Just the reputation, just the brand, just the data as examples, and the customer relationship, which means the supply chain. I'm often being asked around the race between two particular company styles. Insurance is being seen as a commodity and not as an asset, particularly for many of these companies. The way to change this is the way to focus on intangible assets. It's about customer connection. How do you work with your customer together? How do you analyze their needs? How do you assess what is required going forward? And most important, how do you make sure you remain relevant with your products? The media industry, or particularly the music industry, is one big example to show how disruption is coming in and disrupting out a whole industry. Another one, the print industry, gone pretty much today. 50% of the jobs over the next couple of years will either not exist in the way they are, or they will go in a total different direction in this field. The oil industry, a multi-trillion industry today, is going to be massively replaced over a couple of years by renewable energies. Who is investing into bitcoins? Any one of you? Easy to handle to a certain degree? Is it a risk? Is it the future? Without any doubt. Crypto technology is the future. We are at what I call the dawn of a disruptive area. We are at the beginning of a new age as far as insurance is concerned. Combining financial services with technology. Well, we need to be able to bridge it. Data-driven decisions. Analytics is far more than just data. Analytics is industry knowledge. Analytics is strategic advice. Future successful placement, or even today, in the intangible asset side, is not possible without data-driven decisions. Today, one of the biggest challenges when you have a cyber data breach is nothing else than to respond on time. Okay. AI will allow you to see the DNA of your counterparty to a certain degree and respond on time. Artificial intelligence, the challenge is we need to make sure any artificial intelligence is also working specifically in an ethical way. Whilst devices are becoming our external brains, one in three insurance CEO sees digitalization still as a threat. But at the same token, 95% of the CEOs focus on big data. It's not about just knowing what happened in the past. Stochastics around incidents related to flood, quake, etc. from the past are very important in the form of to price conventional risks. Non-physical damages, they're particularly in the area of intellectual property, for instance, and that means a different way of looking at things. Statistics which might not be out there. For the smart underwriter, the smart broker investing into the data aspect, the technology aspect, the education of the staff, there will be more profitability. So on the forefront has to be innovation. Now, the biggest issue related to innovation is culture. Very often we brought up in a, we are operating in a culture which does not allow to fail. And we need to attract talent from outside, investing into approaching universities, get talents out. Insurance is not boring. Everything is going to be mobile. We'll have things in the cloud. There will be blockchain technology applied, digital money, and Bitcoin. If you want to be successfully underwriting intangible asset risks on a treaty basis, on a fact basis, you can't be here at the end change. You need to be closer to the front. It's not a matter whether you will be hacked. It's a matter that you will be hacked in one way or the other. You can't prevent a hack. What you can focus on is how you detect it, how you respond, and how you control. But what you really need to focus on is not just the what, but the how is the decisive factor. How is it being done? Bad news, data regulations around the world are not aligned, so very difficult to cope. Good news, you need to understand where your data is. Is it in the cloud? Where in the cloud? How do you treat it at the end? Then you can stress test along the side of red teaming. Data itself will be the so-called new gold. What we really need when we talk about intangible risks, we need so-called actionable threat intelligence. That's going to be the new oil of the industry. And the new oil is not data only, and not the systems only. The new currency of the industry is what I call the seamless trust into the product. When I talk about the seamless trust into the product, I really mean true contract and claim certainty. So we must ensure that we have not just the experience related to the technology, the talent specifically, and the skills to compete. Because if we don't compete like this, there will someone come in into this particular industry who's going to disrupt the industry. But we have to find new ways to address client requirements, which are intangibles.